Today, I would like to share the story of Lieutenant Ken Ballard.
Specialist E.J. Murphy.
Staff Sergeant Thomas Fogarty.
Army National Guard Sergeant Patrick Ryan McCaffrey.
Today, my thoughts are with Sergeant David Johnson DeFord, who was killed in Iraq in 2004. He joined the National Guard after 9/11, having already served previously in the Army. He was motivated to serve because he felt he had to do something after the attacks. His sacrifice is one of so many that we need to recognize this Memorial Day.
Today, I honor the service and sacrifice of Staff Sergeant Frank Tia'i of American Samoa, someone who I had the privilege and honor of serving with during our deployment to Iraq. On July 17, 2005, Frank was on his final patrol before he was to head home for his 2 weeks of scheduled R&R leave. He was killed on that patrol by an IED that exploded beneath his vehicle.
Today I'm thinking about one of my heroes from the Iraq War, James Hassel of Alabama. James and I were in a building with several other Marines in Najaf in 2004. When insurgents were rolling hand grenades down the stairs at us. And another Marine in the platoon, Ryan from Vermont, was gravely wounded. James saved Ryan's life by putting him on his back and carrying him through brutal machine gun fire to safety.
On June 12, 1952, Henry Savella, a Newark native in Korea, gave the ultimate sacrifice. He threw himself on a grenade to protect his platoon. I honor his memory.
Staff Sergeant Thomas Fogarty, killed in Afghanistan in 2012. Thomas was killed by an IED. He always wanted to serve in the military and enlisted in the Army after 9/11. He had only been in Afghanistan 1 month when he was killed, leaving behind a wife and 2 sons.
Today I remember Specialist E.J. Murphy of Brockton, Massachusetts. He was killed on May 26, 2017, when his vehicle rolled over. He was in Syria serving in Operation Inherent Resolve. He was 22 years old.
Lieutenant Ken Ballard, a native of Mountain View, California, right out of high school, he joined the Army and served 3 years. He planned to serve in the Army for 2 more years and then earn a master's degree and work in Washington, D.C. He lost his life on Memorial Day weekend in 2004 in Iraq, where he was a tank commander.
Army National Guard Sergeant Patrick Ryan McCaffrey. He was on a tour of duty in Iraq on patrol, and he died in 2004 at age 34. Sergeant McCaffrey was known for living his life with integrity and professionalism. And he paid the ultimate sacrifice for our country.
I'm grateful for and thinking of Special Forces Sergeant First Class James F. Grissom of Hayward, California. Sergeant Grissom died March 21, 2013. He was wounded while serving in support of Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan, his 5th overseas deployment.
Staff Sergeant Christopher Birdwell, United States Army, Afghanistan, August 27, 2012. Sergeant Birdwell's company found themselves stopped due to an IED explosion along their route. They came under fire from a gunman in an Afghan convoy that was supposed to be there to help them secure the area. Sergeant Birdwell was killed in the green on blue attack, but he was able to protect another soldier who had been injured in the initial IED blast. His actions that day earned him the Bronze Star, the Purple Heart, and our eternal gratitude.
This Memorial Day, my specific thoughts are with Army Sergeant Sherwood Baker, who was killed in Baghdad in 2004. He made the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom, for our liberty, and for his country.
Sergeant James Ayoub, killed September 2010. James was killed by a suicide bomber in Afghanistan. He was a Boy Scout and chose to become an Army medic to help save the lives of those who served this country. Instead, he gave his own life.
I want to talk to you about Seth DeVoren from East Brunswick, New Jersey. Seth died, an Army lieutenant, on February 3rd, 2004. When he had come back from Iraq, taken a family visit, went back, and 17 days later, he had been killed. He was killed when he tried to dismantle a roadside bomb in order to save the lives of others.
Today, my thoughts are on firefighter Christopher Slutman, a U.S. Marine killed in action this April. He was a 15-year veteran of the FDNY, and I had the honor of meeting him several years ago and awarding him for bravery, as he served us with such distinction as he served his nation.